to the ball game, or to the scene of any special event where news is being made on the spot. He built large transmitters, as well as all the other specialized equipment that he saw would be required to develop a high quality of television reception, broadcasting, and programming. Through the same years, building on the foundation laid in 1938, Dumont was setting up what was to be the first wholly owned television network. The great studio facilities of today began as experimental telecasting, which tested and established the principles of operation. As more and more people began to own sets, Dumont pioneered in setting up regularly scheduled programs for the public to watch, and the Dumont network grew, began to reach out into the East, to the Midwest, across the nation. And the big shows, the wonderful front row entertainment, the entire world began to pour into American homes everywhere. Techniques of television have improved and are improving so fast their progress is visible even to the most casual observer. A whole population of men and women have become skilled in the technical aspects of this new medium. All this was part of the original vision of Alan B. Dumont. But even as the vast field of home entertainment and education has proved too small for the giant that television has become, so was it too small for Dumont. He was constantly seeking to develop and develop again the marvelous servant that is electronics. Take the case of the cathode ray tube, for example. You will remember it looked like this originally. But this was merely a temporary state. Through the years, many changes have been made, both in the shape and the design of the tube. Naturally, these changes have had a profound influence on the picture tube in your television set. Here you see how, under Dumont's leadership, viewing area has grown from 17 inches to 19, to 21, and finally to the fabulous Dumont 30-inch tube, the largest in the world. Notice especially that the larger tubes, even with their vastly increased viewing area, have been greatly reduced in overall length. This makes possible the compact smartness of present-day television receivers. But of course, as Dumont planned, the uses of the cathode ray tube were not confined to home entertainment. Here, for example, is Dumont's new cathode ray tube actually containing 5 electron guns. This 5-gunner is able to record many impulses and reactions simultaneously, able to perform veritable electronic miracles. In fact, the advanced research continually demanded by Dumont and furnished by top electronic scientists not only led and paralleled the development of television, it also branched off to open up entirely new fields. The principles of television transmission and reception did more than just provide entertainment for the millions. Today, these same principles are the basis for industrial television, where manufacturing operations can be seen and controlled from hundreds of feet away. These methods do more than just increase efficiency. They add tremendously to the safety of workers, particularly in vital atomic research and construction. Soon, entire transportation systems may also be run safely and efficiently by the use of electronic equipment. Cathode ray oscillographs and similar instruments play important parts in areas once far remote from electronics. In science and medicine, these instruments make possible new tests and analyses that safeguard health, detecting illness in the human body almost before it starts. Everywhere, electronic principles are being turned into new comfort and convenience for you. So that's the story of television, the story of a whole new era of telectronics that is really just beginning. It's come a long way from here, and it has a much longer way to go. A story, like many others, possible only in the United States of America. Today, in the field of electronics, and tomorrow, as in the years of yesterday, Dumont will be first, for vision is the Dumont dimension.